Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain knowledge. Moses was the first prophet to record scriptures that we know of. But is that true? And if not, why would we think it is? We tend to think Moses was the first prophet because Moses documented Genesis. In fact, Moses wrote most of the Torah, which are the first five books of the Old Testament. And as far as organization, it makes some sense that Genesis should come first, because it starts with a great opening phrase, "In the beginning." But there are some books of the Bible which are considered older than the book of Genesis. One example is Job, considered to be the oldest, but I will not be following that trail at this time. Still, we commonly think Moses was the first because of the way the Bible is organized. In fact, I'd suggest that the Torah, being the foundational revelation from Yahweh, deserved to be first. Even Jesus gave it a principal position when he summarized his teaching to the disciples after his resurrection. Luke 24:25. Then Jesus said to them, "O foolish ones, how slow are your hearts to believe all that the prophets have spoken? Was it not necessary for the Christ to suffer these things and then enter his glory?" And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was written in all the scriptures about himself. Beginning with Moses. So Jesus started with Moses as the foundation when Jesus refuted the message of the prophets. But Jesus claimed he was written about all through the Old Testament. Luke 24:44. Jesus said to them, "These are the words I spoke to you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses," that's the Torah, "the prophets, and the Psalms." Elsewhere, Jesus taught that Moses spoke about Jesus. John 5:46. "For if you believed Moses, you would believe me, because he wrote about me. But if you do not believe his writings, how will you believe my words?" You pore over the scriptures because you presume that by them you possess eternal life. "These are the very words that testify about me. Yet you refuse to come to me that you may have life." This word life is zoein, coming from zoe. From the Strong's, word 2222, zoe, life, physical and spiritual. All life throughout the universe is derived. It always only comes from and is sustained by God's self-existent life. The Lord intimately shares his gift of life with people, creating each in his image, which gives all the capacity to know his eternal life. So Jesus claims that he has the ability to give this eternal life. Where else does Moses talk about Jesus? Deuteronomy 18:15. "The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your countrymen. You shall listen to him." And three verses later, Yahweh, God, confirms what Moses has said. "I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him." So Moses foretold a prophet to Israel who would be Jewish, or from Israel. And the Jews knew and understood this to be the meaning of what Moses taught. In fact, the Jews knew they were looking for a prophet who would come from Israel. That is why when John the Baptist came, they asked him the following. John 1:21. "Who are you then?" they inquired. "Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." The Jews were looking for the prophet to fulfill Deuteronomy 18. And after the resurrection, the disciples referenced Deuteronomy 18 as they shared the gospel of Jesus. Acts 3:18, but in this way God has fulfilled what he foretold through all the prophets, saying that his Christ would suffer. Repent then and turn back so that your sins may be wiped away. That times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord, and that he may send Jesus, the Christ, who has been appointed for you. Heaven must take him in until the time comes for the restoration of all things, which God announced long ago through his holy prophets. For Moses said, "The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among your brothers. You must listen to him in everything he tells you." So the disciples who Jesus had taught also taught Jesus was the prophet of Deuteronomy. And Stephen referenced Deuteronomy 18 as well. This Moses, whom they had rejected with the words, "Who made you ruler and judge?" is the one God sent to be their ruler and redeemer through the angel who appeared to him in the bush. He led them out and performed wonders and signs in the land of Egypt, at the Red Sea, and for 40 years in the wilderness. This is the same Moses who told the Israelites, "God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among your brothers." So we know Moses mentioned Jesus because Jesus said Moses spoke about him. What else did Moses say or do that perhaps revealed Jesus? Before the Exodus, the seventh plague was the spirit of death. God instructed Moses for each house to sacrifice a lamb, and the blood of the lamb was to be placed on the doorposts. And the angel of death would pass over any house marked with the blood of the lamb. And to this very day, the annual feast of the Lord is called Passover or Pesach. The slaughtered lamb is a symbol of Yeshua, the Lamb of God. John 1:29. The next day, John seeth Jesus coming unto him and saith, "Behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world." In fact, Yeshua was crucified during the annual observance of the Feast of Passover. And Yeshua fulfilled several details of the handling of the Lamb of Sacrifice. Isaiah 53:7. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to slaughter, and like a sheep that is silent before its shearers, so he did not open his mouth. Matthew 26:63. But Jesus remained silent. Then the high priest said to him, "I charge you under oath by the living God, tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God." Mark 14:61. But Jesus remained silent and made no reply. Again the high priest questioned him, "Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?" Seems the high priest also knew the Messiah, the Christ, was the Son of God. Exodus 12:46. It is to be eaten in a single house. You are not to bring forth any of the flesh outside of the house, nor are you to break any bone of it. John 19:33. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs. Now these things happened so that the scripture would be fulfilled, "Not one of his bones will be broken." And in Numbers 9:12, "They shall leave none of it until morning, nor break a bone of it, according to the statute of the Passover, they shall observe it." The symbol of the Passover lamb represents Yeshua, later sacrificed on Passover. When Moses led the children of Israel, he put a serpent on a pole, and this was a symbol of Jesus. John 3:14, "And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone believing in him, Jesus, may have eternal life." Are there any other mentions or symbols of Jesus in the Torah which Moses revealed? I'm sure there are many, many, many more. In fact, the book of Revelation calls Messiah the Lamb of God slain from the foundation of the world. Revelation 13:8. and all that dwell upon the earth shall worship him, the beast, all whose names are not written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. So we know Moses wrote about Jesus the Christ, the Messiah, the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. We know Moses revealed the Passover lamb, which served one purpose, but also revealed Messiah, the Lamb of God. Believe the prophets of God, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Amen.